Because I want everybody to have an opportunity to share in giving with what's happening right now in the Back to Jerusalem movement. If you don't understand the Back to Jerusalem movement, it's not some kind of crusader mentality about going back to Jerusalem for some unique reason. It's really taking in the unreached people groups, because there's right now at this point in time easily 2.5 billion people who've never heard the gospel one single time. It's probably more like 3 billion if we started saying, well, let's define it based on what Jesus said, this gospel of the kingdom must be preached to all the nations of the earth as a witness and as a testimony, and then the end shall come. And so if we take we take that as a definition, this gospel of the kingdom, the one that Jesus preached, the way he preached it, the way that Paul preached it, as he imitated Christ Jesus, when he said, I fully preach the gospel from Jerusalem to Illyricum, and that so that by mighty signs and wonders and demonstration of the Holy Ghost, the gospel has been preached. And so we are joining together with the Back to Jerusalem movement, which is something that was birthed out of China. And it's really a concept of saying, let's take the gospel to the unreached people groups standing between China and Israel. And of course, it's beyond, because we've got all of the Horn of Northern Africa. And well, there is more unreached people groups when you take that window of area in the earth than any place else on the earth. And so one of the reasons that we are part of what Brother Yun is doing is because of that mandate that Father gave him. Now, somebody said, are you sure that God gave him that mandate? And yes, we are certain of it. That's why the Lord released him from a prison that he was not supposed to get out of. Actually, he preserved his life, because actually Brother Yun should have been killed at that moment in time. Ann and I have had the privilege of staying with the people that Brother Yun was with after he was out of prison and was recovering from the injuries that he received there in the jail cell. How many of you ever have read the book, The Heavenly Man? Would you raise your hand? So if you've read the book, then you know what I'm talking about. And if you haven't read the book, I want to encourage you to read the book. It's really a continuance of the book of Acts, because we are in the continuance of the book of Acts. Praise God for the book of Acts as it is recorded in the Bible, and we get to see the first century church, but same church. I belong to the same church that the Apostle Paul belongs to, and belong to and currently belongs to. How about you? What church do you belong to? Come on. I belong to the church that Jesus Christ purchased with his own blood. Amen. And tell you, it's been living for 2,000 years, and it's the vehicle of the kingdom of God, and it's going to explode one day into a great and majestic reign of Christ Jesus on this earth for 1,000 years, and then Father is going to make a new heaven and a new earth. After that, the last enemy, death, is subdued. Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God. Well, I'm going to have to be careful. The anointing's here. The anointing's for anyone to have. I don't have Parkinson's, but I do have the shakes in the Holy Ghost every once in a while. I'm sorry about that if it's weird. A lot of things go on in the kingdom of God that to the natural thinking is weird, strange, and people trying to predict what's going on. I'm telling you, what God wants to do with your life is unpredictable. It's, well, unpredictable by you, but it's already been declared in the Word of God if you just read it and believe that, those things Father would actually do in your life. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. So today, this morning, before Brother Yun really gets into it deep, I want to give you an opportunity to worship the Lord in giving. Now, I want you to understand, I'm not giving you an invitation for tithes here today. Tithes is a 10% that goes into the local church. We believe that. We just believe the divine word of God. We're asking you to participate in your giving through taking care of these things that belong to the Great Commission of go into all the world and preach the gospel. Right now, Iran is a hot spot for Back to Jerusalem. Right now, northern Iraq is a hot spot. Look at what's going on in northern Iraq. I mean, we're just been so moved with compassion with the churches that Back to Jerusalem are participating with and giving relief to those folks who are flocking to the churches. The churches of the Lord Jesus Christ in an effort to escape what ISIL is doing and other groups that are persecuting Christians. And so it's such a blessing. I would love to go to Northern Iraq. I wanted to go to Northern Iraq in 2001. We were on our way to Baghdad. A crusade was already being set up, and unfortunately it was interrupted. But Father's program is not going to ultimately be interrupted here. Father's going to do great things. Amen. Somebody said, how are we going to preach the gospel to Saudi Arabia, to Mecca? I've got a great plan. Ramadan, I've got a plan for preaching the gospel at Ramadan in Mecca, Saudi Arabia. Would anybody like to hear that? And this, I'm just talking about creative things in the Back to Jerusalem movement. Just three, four people want to hear my plan. The rest of you might be in shock. I really got a plan. You might think this strange, but I believe that if I stood on the platform in Ramadan and I came in by means of a miraculous entry and I began to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, and about the time they were ready to take me and kill me, I disappeared or vanished out of their sight, as Jesus did many times. Amen. And then came back about 30 minutes to an hour later would have some folks' attention.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now, you might say, that's weird. I'm going to tell you right now, I believe this. God's put it on the inside of me. Nothing is impossible for them to believe. Jesus said, these works which I've done, and shall you do in greater works than these, because I go to my Father. I believe. Jesus said, if any man believes in me. And so this is why I'm so hooked up with this man, because he shares this fire of God that has been placed on the inside of me. And I mean, when I first went to China, I thought, oh no, if I get there and find a bunch of religious people sitting around in a room crying, I'm going to be totally upset. But when I got there, I found fiery people full of the Holy Ghost, willing to go lay down their life in taking the gospel to the unreached people groups. And I said, my goodness, somebody's got the fire. Hallelujah. Woohoo!
Man.
Yeah.
Man.
So, we're going to partner with them. You can't go. You're a big nose. And that means that you're a Westerner, right? And you're going to stick out like a sore thumb, and more than likely what you're going to do is create problems for folks there. And so, we send those who fit right in and are very, you know, have a run right up the middle, as it were, to operate with the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. We get to partner with them, in other words, in our giving today. You get to go by way of your finances. Mm-hmm. I pray that all of your money means to you a way in which you can proclaim the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, both here and abroad, in your own hometown and the uttermost parts of the earth. I pray in Jesus' name that that's what your money means to you. That your money does not mean to you how you're going to keep yourself with your house, what food you're going to eat, what clothes you're going to wear. Because I'm going to tell you right now, your life is more than meat, your body more than raiment. Jesus said, take no thought of it, and I'll bless you. People look at me and they say, how do you do it? Where did you get the money to buy this $14 million property? I'm telling you, I don't need money. I function in another realm. It's called faith. Somebody said, how did you go here? How did you go there? How did you do that? People stand around going, my goodness, how on earth? Where did you get the money? Did your business partners do it? No. How did you meet those people? Faith. God opens up doors for you that no man can shut. Everybody want to slow you up, but God will speed you up. Amen. So today we want you to believe that. We want you to partner with us in this. We want you to know that Father has told us to take care of the widows. He told us to take care of the orphans. He told us to take care of the needy. He told us to take care of the local church and traveling ministry. Five areas of giving. That's what Papa said. Now, I figure somebody got to be really wealthy to do all that. Come on, where is anybody going to get up that much money when we got to take care of our mortgage and everything else? Give me a break. Well, here's the promise that we have from the Father, and he cannot lie. He said this. He said, if you sow generously, you're going to also reap generously. And Father is so good and gracious. He said, if you sow sparingly, you'll even reap sparingly. So he's going to give you harvest one way or the other. So according to your faith this morning, we want you to hook up with us. I know, Taisto, you were just in Northern Iraq, weren't you?
Yeah.
With the Kurds.
Yeah.
And so listen, dear people, I mean, wouldn't you just love to go take care of those kids right now in Northern Iraq among the Kurdish folks? Wouldn't you love to do that? I would love to do that. Yeah. Unfortunately, I can't go right now because Father's got a lot of things on my plate, but Taisto and Brother Yuen and others are going to go. And so, once again, we're going to give you an opportunity. If you're writing a check, I don't want you to get ready because we're going to give you that opportunity right now. I want you to prayerfully do it. Somebody said, how much money really will go to taking care of these relief issues and taking care of the advancement of the gospel and the things that are being done by Back to Jerusalem. I'm telling you 100%. Somebody said, well, don't you take out overhead and then call that 100%? I don't take out overhead. God's got my, Jesus said my overhead. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Amen.
He's head over everything I got
Amen.
Going on, okay?
Over us as
so
well.
The bottom line of it is someone said, how are you going to take care of your needs and your issues? He supplies all my needs according to his riches and glory. I mean, that's how. And I pray that you understand that as well. I want you to step into that. You participate with us in faith by your giving, and I guarantee you we'll hook up with you in faith in terms of how God will resource you to do the things that he's commanded and called you to do. So if you're making out checks, you can make out your check to simply just go APM, which stands for Abiding Place Ministry. APM. That's easy. Everybody got that one? Say APM. And we will write the check to Back to Jerusalem. And we promise you, we here's what we believe. We believe that all liars shall have their part in the lake of fire. Are you with me? That's what Papa says. All liars shall have their part in the lake of fire. I'm telling you, everything that you get will go to the Back to Jerusalem movement. There will be no overhead. There will be no percent take or whatever else people seem to be lost in. Because there's been, somebody said, well, there's been this abuse of finances. I tell you right now, show me one abuse of finances, I'll show you 10,000 people who didn't abuse the finances. It's just that the enemy of our soul wants to highlight the abusers. Amen. So today we want you to know that, your finances are safe in the kingdom of God. They're all going to the kingdom of God. And let me just say this, just to give you another closure on that.
Hallelujah.
When you give, Father receives it directly as you're giving to him directly.
Hallelujah.
And so there's no interference there either. So APM, if you're giving by way of cash, make it more than you would if you were giving by way of check. Well, sir, should I say that again? If you're giving by cash, make it more than what you would give by way of check. Ha, ha, ha. And does everybody speak English here? And if you're giving by credit card, once again, make it big. Because I don't know, when is the next time you're going to get a chance to give in a meeting that Brother Yun's in to Back to Jerusalem movement to go take care of the folks that are in Iran, Iraq, and is there any other big target right now? I know Northern Korea. I know we just did Northern Korea when you guys were here last year.
Yeah.
We went into North Korea.
Yeah.
I think the finances, something like 11 or 12,000, somebody would have to remind me what came in the offering. And immediately it went to Northern Korea, and aquaponics was built.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's a soul-winning station.
Yeah.
It looks like an aquaponics on the outside, but it's a soul-winning station. Lots of great things happen in North Korea.
Yeah.
So once again, is there any real target right now?
Yeah, still the three same targets.
Three same targets.
It's North Korea. The missionaries are working there, so we will feed with material, and we will help them to win the more people to the Lord. So the church is growing. So part of it will be North Korea. Part of it will go to Iran, and then to Northern Iraq. These are three countries.
Right.
Yeah, where we are.
I had it right.
We're good.
Praise God. Okay.
Precisely.
I want everybody to stand with me so that you can get your wallets out and get closer to your checkbook. And I'm just going to pray over you, okay? I'm going to pray over you. Listen to me. Hey, everybody. Listen, I'm going to pray over you. I know there's a bunch of folks in here who have financial needs. I'm going to take care of that for you, okay? The Lord says he's going to show you how to write upon your high places in him so that he can feed you with the heritage of Jacob.
Man.
So we want to see an anointing increase in your life. We do want to see an anointing increasing in life so the financial provision will also increase. We want to see that happen because you're going to be willing to trust Father with every dimension of your life.
Amen.
So
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name, I command a blessing upon everybody here that's willing to live by the promises of Isaiah chapter 58. I command a blessing upon everybody here who's going to make the plan of the kingdom of God their most important issue, first the kingdom and everything else second. In the name of Jesus, I break the back of whack. I destroy everything that the powers of darkness is trying to do to prevent you from fulfilling the divine commission that's been placed upon your life in Jesus' name. So what we want everybody to do is we want you just to all come, and this way we do it around here, and we want you to march up here. We got offering baskets on either side. Jesus is here. He's looking to see what it is that you're giving. If you only have two mites, don't worry about it, because the Lord really gets excited about two mites that are all your finances affects you all the way to the point of, amen, of your living. So,
amen.
Hallelujah. So just come, everybody. Just come on.
Amen.
Amen. Just come, hallelujah, on up. Everybody, just come, hallelujah, on up. Everybody has something to give. Mm-hmm. Just come on. You want to receive, you got to learn how to, you're going to have to learn how to give. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise God. Father, I thank you for the blessing on those, amen, who are giving. I just thank you, Father, for the anointing and increase in the manifest presence,
amen,
of your spirit, amen, in their life. Father, thank you for,
amen,
provision.
Amen.
Father, I thank you for increase in financial means, brother, to do the work of the ministry. Father, I thank you that you're able to put resources in our hands as good stewards,
amen,
to take care of the many things that that needs to be done in reaching 2.5 billion unreached peoples. Amen. Amen. There's more than a half a billion orphans right now. You can reach them easy. You start taking care of orphans, and I'm telling you right now, they'll cleave to you and cleave to Jesus. Goodness gracious. You take up Middle East right now, you start taking care of the older folks, and you start taking care, or any part, yeah, of Asia. Take care of the older folks, yeah, and also take care of the younger folks, and you'll reach the nation. It's true. I mean, the amount of finances that it takes to do that is astronomical. And if you focused on that, you wouldn't get anywhere. But when you look at all provision that is given to us in the faith of Jesus Christ, man, we can get it all done in a generation.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Easily.
Easily. Come on, man.
Amen. 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 Okay. Thank you so much. I really want to emphasize that this meeting this morning is not about your money. Don't be mistaken. But it's giving you an opportunity to sow in what God is doing today.
Amen.
You know that it's written in the Bible about King David after he served God's purpose for his own generation. He fell asleep and he died. And that's a very relevant question this morning. Is my life and everything that I have, is it serving the fullness of God's purpose for this generation? And I have to be honest, God is not that interested to keep the church business going among Christians in countries where people have heard the gospel thousands of times. He is more committed to bring the light to the darkness. He's more committed to bring the light of his Son to those who never have heard that there is a Savior and his name is Jesus Christ. So this is what the Back to Jerusalem is about. It's not a fancy name. We can come up with anything else. So let's call it Back to Jerusalem. Jerusalem is just the final stop of the train. It's nothing more, it's nothing less. But the question is, and the challenge is, what do we do along the track? How many stops we do? Where is the kingdom of God going today? And we really pray, and there are tens of thousands of people in China praying, Lord, help us to stop at the right location at the right time so that your kingdom will take a form in that society.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yeah.
We don't care if we have money or not, because a lack of money have never stopped the kingdom of God to go forward.
That's right.
I don't believe that God has any financial crisis for his business. So that's with great confidence when we heard the calling from the men of Macedonia, come and help us. We don't look, oh, how much money do we have on the Back to Jerusalem account? It may be on the freezing cold, no money, but we will still go. Because wherever God's kingdom is about to burst, there will be kingdom resources right there, that moment. Not week before, not maybe even 5 minutes before, but when you need it, it will be there. I give you a fresh example. I'm so excited about this new era of missions, where we very clearly recognize that God is selecting the people groups who have totally been isolated from the gospel for hundreds of years. They never have heard about Jesus. And suddenly, he starts to work among these people groups. And God is amazing. When he works, he does not always do it in nice way. He does not do it in very, very sweet way and very pleasant way. But today, with great confidence, I tell you, and this may be difficult for you to believe, we praise God for ISIS, this terrorist group, because actually what they are doing now, they are pulling up from their roots and from their culture, from their barricaded villages. They have to run for their lives, and they become refugees. And there are we welcoming them. Come into kingdom of God. Can you imagine the Yardidis people group, about 1 million of them? They've been for hundreds of years living in these barricaded societies in northern Iraq. Right. But ISIS came, and they have to run for their lives. Many were slaughtered, were crucified, were killed. And their children were hijacked, and their women were raped. It was a most horrible situation going on in northern Iraq today. And it's been going on already more than 6 months. So they have to move. And the only safe haven they have found for these people is northern Turkey, which is also a Muslim country. So they are hated by the Muslims in Turkey. But it's still they can survive. So there they are. And when I was walking among them, I was listening. They have big families, 8 to 12 children. And they have been walking for days, 7 days over the mountains. They didn't have any water. So until the halfway of the escape up in the high mountains, some of the bold fathers, they returned every night back to their own villages, and they were carrying tens of gallons of water so that they will not thirst to death up in the mountains. There's nothing to eat, but the lack of water is even more difficult. But then they finally arrived to northern Turkey. And together with the church in Turkey, we have now launched an effort that every Yardidis person will hear that there is one Savior, and he speaks fluently their language. Amen. And it was interesting. I talked with one guy. He was a university professor from northern Iraq, belonging to this people group. And he said, "Man, we have lost everything. There is nothing left. And now, after all this difficulty, we finally make it here, and we feel and we experience nobody loves us. The food they provide, we almost vomit after every meal. And still, the local government tried to do their thing. And actually, the amazing thing is that the United Nations and the Turkish government does not even admit that the Yardidis people have flooded into Turkey. They don't exist on the radar. They are only concerned about the Kurds coming from Syria. Every refugee coming out from Syria will register by United Nations, and they get the refugee status in Turkey. But all these Yardidis people, nobody even believes that they exist, but they are there. And now the gospel is among them. And they will hear that Jesus is the Savior of every Yardidis person, and they have a possibility to become sons and daughters of living God. Yeah. Hallelujah. I can imagine these movements of people groups. It's stirring up a region where the former Ottoman Empire is on the fire. And we think that it's just because of evil. No, God is preparing some growth for his kingdom. If you go to a jungle anywhere in this world, And you go day after, there has been a fire in the jungle. All what you see is that it's black. It's all burnout. There seems not to be any life at all. It's just so horrible. It's like you are walking on the moon. But it only takes few drops of water from heaven. You don't need gulls of it, just few drops of living water. And the nature will arise. And they worship God. And this is what is happening in that region right now. Praise God. Now, almost has become like a tradition. I just want to say this first. We really feel that this church is one of our best partners in for Back to Jerusalem. I really, really honor you, Brother Mark, and your wonderful wife, your whole extended family. You guys are so sold for Kingdom of God. I cannot do any changes into your life. Just go with the vision God has given to you. We bless you every day as we remember your labor for this. But so thank you very much. And thank you for this offering. Every dollar you gave to this offering today, or will, if you want to follow us on the backtojerusalem.com website, you can do that. Every dollar will unredacted go into this. Brother Yun and Sister Turling and my personal expenses have been totally covered by other parties. So we do this for free. Our housing, our traveling costs, wherever we go, we are the most low-priced preachers you ever got to your church. We don't take any of that. Everything will go to expand the kingdom of God so that we can do it faster, so that we can reach longer and further with the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So, how many of you have seen a device that we have made in China called Gospel Cloud? Have you seen it? Okay, so those of you who have not seen it, I show it. This is Gospel Cloud. And this is the most amazing device ever been designed in China. Most of the devices are made in China. But this is the top of the top. Because this little device will create what is called the cloud, Gospel Cloud. It will create the presence of Kingdom of God any place where it is placed. So about 200 yards circle, every person who is inside that circle will have full access to the kingdom of God through this device. I have never had any tool, ministry tool, before in my hand that is so efficient, that is so complete, so that you can have, I've been walking with it into a mosque in Tehran. And you may think, what in the world were you doing that? Of course, expanding the kingdom of God. There's nothing dangerous in the mosque. It's an empty tomb. There is no life in the mosque unless Jesus will come and change their hearts. So with Gospel Cloud in my pocket, it's totally innocent. The guard, security guard, what is this? Oh, this is just my personal device. What does it do? It does not do any harm to anybody. That's my answer. So inside here, we have several Bibles. You can immediately get access to the Word of God. You can listen to the Word of God. You can watch the Word of God. We can put inside this more than 100 full night movies about Jesus into this device. And anyone who goes, oh, I don't like that title, but this title applies. And they push that button, and from their own device, they can get access immediately. And the streaming is like a lightning. Because the signal does not go to the internet. We have made this is a local internet. So it was only from your device into this device. And so you can download the whole Bible in 3 minutes. So it's completely, and it's so fast. It's faster than any of my thoughts. Praise God. This is really kingdom. And now, the church in many countries. And by the way, we have already committed. We will prepare the way for your pastor, Mark, to get into Mecca. he still have some challenges because a few hundred miles before Mecca and Medina, there is a roadblock and it's completely sealed. Only people who have an identification that they are Muslims are able to pass that control. Nobody else. So you have a little problem. You have to allow your beard to grow a little bit more. And we can copyright a Muslim ID card for you when you intend to go. So I can help with that. Because in China, we don't have any copyrights. We just copy it right. So this device is going to, in the near future, there will be Muslim background believers who are still part of the Muslim community. But every time they go to a mosque, are they praising Allah? No, they are serving the living God. I have been there, I have seen that it's difference between a person who serves, worship the living God and the ones who are worshiping Allah. They stick out, but they are still there. So they are the ones who will carry this in their pocket. With one charging, this will broadcast 24 hours. And it can be connected to a little solar cell thing that will feed it. So it will broadcast 24/7 and create presence. Can you see the LED lights throughout the Islamic world? Suddenly, the message of the gospel of Jesus is in every village, is in every city, every society, just because a simple thing like this. I've never had any this low-cost missionary in my neighborhood. I don't need to have a four-wheeler for them. I don't need to have a sea container of resources so that they can survive. All what I have to have is send one of them to every location, and it will start to broadcast the presence of Kingdom of God. And it has also a little ability in the person who is carrying this can, with his own device, have a chat, have a contact with those who come and enter into this server that is inside. The server is actually this one. So it's very small. If you are in trouble, just eat it like the prophets in the Old Testament. And you are secured for at least 24 hours before it comes out from the other end. So this is what God is doing today. And I really emphasize, remember, God does not repeat the old stuff. He does something new. Yes, he does. I am going to do a new thing, says the Bible in book of Isaiah chapter 43. And the question for you is, like to me tonight, do you see it? Amen? Amen. It's coming. Praise God. And now the church. This is good news for the local church in Iran, in Iraq, in Syria, in Saudi Arabia, Yemen, in Pakistan, all the places where there is a security problem for the church to gather together. Suddenly, we just provide one device. The gospel cloud. And they can put it on the wall of a building or on the wall of the next building. And the signal will come to that underground church meeting. The only thing that people need to have is a receiving device, smaller or bigger. And they push the free Wi-Fi, the gospel cloud, and everybody suddenly have a Bible to read. I don't need to print one more Bible anymore. And then they can watch discipleship training, teaching of pastors all over the place. And everybody can watch that. And then they can have a discussion. What did we learn from this teaching today? And if the security police comes, if they haven't downloaded it, they've just been using what material that is in the server, there's no trace in their devices that they ever been on this site. And they cannot use the devices as they are monitoring the internet in all these countries. There is 100% control on the flow of information through internet. But none of those devices that will reveal where are the people who are on this illegal site in our country right now. And they have these things that are monitoring the atmosphere, and they come with their police force and they capture you. They cannot find this. It's under radar to 110%. They cannot find this. So this is what God is doing, a new thing, and your offerings today will unreducted go into this to reach the gospel with the gospel of Jesus to these countries, North Korea, to Iran. Praise God, the number of Chinese missionaries are increasing almost weekly into Iran. We don't care about the sanctions. We don't care about what the world think about Iran. We believe that 78 million people in Iran, they have to hear that there's only one Savior, and His name is Jesus Christ. And nobody is excluded from this vision. And the same thing is going to happen in country after country. I will finish with you showing you something else. Some of you have not seen the clock Bible. This is the ultimate device for the believers, because you have to see the numbers are so great. When thousands and thousands of people come to the Lord in these countries. Actually, one of the largest revivals right now is happening in Iran. The church growth at house churches in Iran is over 20% annually. So God is doing a new thing in Iran. But for us to provide a device that they would be able to feed their new faith daily has been a challenge. We have been printing Bibles in China. We've been smuggling them into country. We've seen the result of those. But the numbers are so low, just a couple of 10,000 Bibles. So then we went back to the drawing board and we created this little clock. This is a digital clock. It will show every second of your life, 5 years from now, every day, it will show what is the proper time. And if you happen to know the code that you push on these three buttons here on the side, suddenly the whole thing is changed and the word of God will hit you on your face. And this little device, we can put three different language of Bibles into this device. And the battery lasts for 5 years. In these countries, you print the Bible, and there are so few Bibles that 20, maybe 30 people are using the one Bible to read. It lasts maximum 12 months. And then it's just bits and pieces. But with this one, they can read. And suddenly, in countries like North Korea, in Iran, in Saudi Arabia, people have become very conscious about the time. So everybody is walking on the streets and they are looking, what's the time? And they have smile in their eyes and they have tears in their eyes and they are just walking everywhere. And if the security police comes, and they, why are you smiling? You only need to entertain that policeman for 1 minute. Because if you for 1 minute, you don't move on in this text to next chapter of the Bible, then it go back to the clock. So it's 100% foolproof. Then you say, what are you doing? I'm just checking what's the time. And can you see that these millions and millions of new believers are now walking in the streets of Tehran or any of those other cities with millions of people, and they all have this in their hand and they are reading the word of God. Do you believe that there's power in the Word of God? Yes. Do you believe that there is light in the Word of God? Yes. That's why we feel that the Bible ministry into this region, without exception, is needed so that the foundation, solid foundation for Kingdom of God will be established in that nation. And that's why we do what we are doing. And we are so excited to partner with you. And now let us welcome my blood brother, my dear partner, heavenly man, Yntisio Nikaisanga.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
这是耶和华所定的日子，伸出你的手，对你身边人说：“不要怕。”
And now this is the day that the Lord has made. Say no to one another. Don't be afraid. 不要怕.
Don't be afraid. 不要怕.
不要怕. In Chinese, 不要怕. In English, don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid. Chinese author.
不要怕.
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 Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
He starts to speak in tongues.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
不要怕, 耶稣爱你。
Don't be afraid because Jesus loves you.
上一次来教各位, 耶稣爱你, 大家会讲了吗? 耶稣?
Do you still remember I taught you last time how to say yeah? Jesus loves you?
耶稣爱, 耶稣?
耶稣爱你。
Okay. Amen. 但是你必须要知道, 我们的神, 祂不偏待人, 但是祂偏爱人。
And we have to remember that our Lord Jesus, He always loves all the people.
耶稣爱你, 我今天要教给大家的一句话说, 你爱耶稣。
And now I teach you some more. You will reverse that, what I have been teaching you. Now you say, you love Jesus. 你爱耶稣。
你爱, 我的 English 你,
so in English, this is 你,
你,
and this is
你,
I, okay?
耶稣,
and this is yes,
Amen.
Jesus. Okay,
Amen.
Amen.
耶稣, 爱, 你, 你, 爱, 耶稣, 我们把这两句话合到一起, 耶稣爱你, 你爱耶稣。
Let us repeat these two ways together. 耶稣爱你, 你爱耶稣。
每一个人都能够成为宣教士，可以去国华人传福音。
Now you are all qualified to be missionaries to Chinese.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
有多少人和我一样的相信？ 新旧约圣经就是神的话，耶稣的话语是永远不改变的。
How many of you believe that the Old and New Testament together is the living word of God and it never changes? Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我是天上人云弟兄。
They call me heavenly man.
我感谢神，我来到这里之前的时候，神安排我有一次去到瑞士一个主日。
Before we started this Blessed Enemies tour in U.S., 2 weeks ago, I was ministering in Switzerland.
当时我们说讲的信息是爱你的仇敌。当时有几个人，他们听的时候，那一天都开始跪下来哭。第二天就打电话给我。
And we were sharing the same message as we are doing today. We have to bless our enemies. And as we were doing that, there were people coming from different nations of the world. And they embraced that blessing of the Lord into their lives.
他们说：“袁弟兄，你讲的爱你的仇敌，我们是再到一个那个社会福利的一个好像难民营一样的，里面是天主教的修士办的，里面是犹太人，里面又是穆斯林，都是基督的。”
Somebody from a center. It was kind of a refugee center. They've been working there. They came to the meeting and they said, we are working in a location where the leadership of that center, they are Catholics and they are Jewish, and then most of the people are Muslims.
那我来到这里的时候，他就打电话来的时候，他说这里不是基督徒，可是我希望你能够来看一看这里，这里的人真正好像在监牢的时候，我们听你的见证，太受感动。
And this brother who were in our Sunday morning meeting. He said, I have no authority to invite you to speak at our center, but I would love you to come and see and these people who are have so many misery in their lives.
那我去的时候，他们这个现任这个里面的领袖，他是在。 他是在宜兰的监牢里面关过七年，刚刚释放不久。
And the second person in charge of the center,
他是个犹太人。
He was a Jewish man who had been spent 7 years in the prison in Iran.
那他的父亲、他的爷爷奶奶都是在到奥斯维茨的时候被活活的时候，
是由纳粹杀掉的。He was originated from a Jewish man from Poland.His grandfather and grandmother were executed, were killed in Auschwitz labor camp.
那我去的时候，他说：“云弟兄，我们只能给你三分钟，希望三分钟之内，因为我们这里的人呢、啊，有不同宗教的人，他们是来吃饭的，不要超过三分钟。”
It was just before lunchtime, so the leadership of that center they said, "Brother Yun, we will give you 3 minutes to share to these people."And they have actually come from the streets, some of them, just to have a free lunch at our center. So before the lunch, we give you 3 minutes.
我立刻有一句话说，神的话句句是带能力的，一分钟也可以。
And I immediately felt in my spirit, 1 minute is enough, because the power is in every word of God.
哈利路亚！
哈利路亚！
那我去的时候，我都问有多少人去过中国，没有一个人去过中国。
So、I started with, I asked how many of you have visited China, and nobody ever been in China.
那我就告诉他，我从前跟你们一样，我在监牢里面，但是我的监牢跟你们一些人不一样，我是在另外一个监牢里面判刑过14年，在真正的监牢里面待过七十年。
And I said to these men and women, in the past.My life situation was as difficult as your life has been in that country where you have escaped and become a refugee here. And I have said that I have been sentenced for 14 years imprisonment, and I have totally spent more than 10 years of my life in different prisons.
我说我在监牢的后来遇见一个耶稣，我遇见了耶稣。那他一句话，我怎样走出了监牢？这个故事我今天一定要告诉你，他能把你从你的监牢里面带出来。
And then I told them the very core of my testimony. When I was in the prison last time, one morning, Jesus came to me and he set me free from the prison. And I just want to love to share with you what he did for me.
我说现在大家要吃饭，吃过饭我希望你能够在这里来听。吃过饭很多的人他们真的
来了。And then I said, now my 3 minutes, because I had 2 translators, so I only had 1 minute to share, was to end. And I said, after the lunch, if you want to hear my testimony, come back to this place and I will share the story, what Jesus have done in my life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我就在问他们，你们中间有多少人相信新旧约圣经？是神的话的时候，一个犹太人就告诉我说：“你有很多的犹太人，他就说，我只相信旧约，我没有办法相信新约。”
And I asked them, how many of you believe that Old and New Testament are the living word of God? There were several Jewish people there and said, we only believe in the Old Testament.
那另外有一些他说：“啊，我们是相信安拉的，我们是相信。”
And then a big number of people say, we don't believe in your God, we believe in Allah. They were Muslims.
好了，我说现在我们不谈宗教的事，我来谈一下我怎样遇见到这一位耶稣，他把我从监牢里面带出来。
And then I said, I'm here. I'm not here this morning to share about religion. I'm here to say what Jesus, the living Son of God, did for me. How He set me free from the security prison.
有多少人读过《天上人》这本书啊
？So how many of you have read my story, Heavenly Man? 差不多一半。
哦。好了，差不多超过一半弟兄姊妹，我还是稍微来谈一下。我那一天就在告诉他，我说我在监牢里的时候，我17岁，上帝呼召我传福音，向西向南。
When I how I was 16 years old, young boy in China, and Jesus came to me and He called me to be His witness to West and South.
后来我被关进共产党那个监牢里面，一次、两次、三次、四次。
And then I shared that because of that calling upon my life to be a witness for Jesus, I was captured one time, second time, third time, and thrown to prison in China.
我说我当时在那个监牢里给你们在做的，那这些有很多的人一样，但是你们给我是不一样的监牢，我经历过完全的沮丧、绝望。
And I told to these people, you may think that I cannot solve the problems of my life as a refugee. I have so many difficulties in my life. But I said, I was even in the worst situation in that solitary confinement.
我告诉他们，我说用金钱救不了我了，用政权也政治也救不了我。
And I told them no money was able to set me free from that security prison.
我说美国的总统出面也没有办法了。Not
able to set me free.
那我讲的时候，我遇见主的时候，主说现在你这个门开了。
But when this man Jesus came into my cell and said, stand up and walk out from the prison, the doors of prison were supernaturally opened for me, and I walk out from this prison.
我那一天还让他们，我说我在监牢里两条腿打断了，你们可以看我两条腿上的伤吗？
And then I pulled up my pants and I saw. Before I met Jesus that morning. My both legs been crushed by a sledgehammer. I was completely handicapped. I couldn't walk. But I still have the wounds in my legs. You can come and see. But he healed me, and I walked out from the prison.
我说，Hallelujah！Hallelujah！ 我说，我今天在这里不是讲宗教了，因为有天主教、有犹太教、有穆斯林，还有基督教不同的宗派。
And I said, but I'm here not here to talk about religion. Because I know you come from totally different kind of religious background. You are maybe Catholic, you are maybe Protestant, you are Muslim, or you are Jewish.
我说我今天来跟你讲这一位耶稣。如果你在监牢里，不管是个什么样的监牢，
introduce this Jesus Christ for you. No matter what is your prison. He is able to set you free.
我说我知道你们中间有一些是戒毒，很多次戒不了在这里，那是个毒品的监牢。
And I said to these people, I know and I can see some of you are in the prison of drugs. You have been using drugs so long in your life, you cannot set you free anymore. But my Jesus is able.
我说我们有的人是在一个宗教的监牢里面，立志没有自由，心中没有喜乐。
And some of you are prisoners of religion. You feel my religion has become my prison. I have no freedom in my life.
我说有的人是在一个忧郁症的监牢里，每一天都没有喜乐，也睡不了觉，也没有办法工作。
And then there are some of you have lost all your hope for survival. Your joy is not there anymore. You are complaining. You are in tears, suffering every day.
我说不要怕。
Don't be afraid.
耶稣活着，你能面对明天。Just
because Jesus is alive, you can face tomorrow.
Hallelujah. 就当时就有一个穆斯林，他然后就出来了，他说我是穆斯林。And
then one man rushed to me and he said, "I'm a Muslim."
我已经5年了，我没有办法解脱这个痛苦，我晚上没有办法睡觉，我也没有办法工作。
And this man started to share about his agony and the pain of his heart. He said, "For the last 5 years, I have not been able to sleep by night, and I'm so worried about everything, and I'm just have no hope in my life."
我说我今天不听你给我讲宗教，我现在就是你渴望得自由吗？他说我渴望。
And I asked this man. I said, "I am not interested about your religion. I just ask you a relevant question. Do you want to be set free? Do you want to be set free from that is holding back your life?"
他就开始就说，我说那就奉耶稣的名跪下来，我怎么说，你就怎么说就可以了。
And then he asked, "How is this supposed to happen?" I said, "Very simple. Kneel down, and I kneel by your side, and then you repeat a prayer after me."
Hallelujah! 当我奉耶稣的名为他祷告，他跟我做决志祷告，那一刹那，真的他的天完全亮了。
And once again, I saw the power of the gospel of Jesus Christ. As I was leading him into a prayer of acceptance of the salvation of God, the power of God hit that man, and he was totally set free.
哈利路亚，
哈利路亚，
这是我最兴奋的一个时刻。天主教的人、犹太教的人，还有穆斯林，然后归到一起，我就开始拉住他们祷告。
And that's because what happened to this Muslim man, the Jewish men and women, the other, the Catholic priest and the others, they all kneeled down and they wanted to pray and receive Jesus into their lives.
哈利路亚。对你身边说，不要怕，耶稣也能给你自由。
Now say this to one another aloud. Don't be afraid. Jesus will set you free.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
好，我再给弟兄姊妹做一个见证。我非常感谢马可，神的仆人，几年前顺服神的声音，去到了山东。把这个复兴的火给到山东的弟兄姊妹。
I'm going to continue with another wonderful testimony. I'm so thankful to you, Brother Mark, of your obedience that one day you came to China, you went to Shantung province, and you met with a local church in Shantung, my dear friends.
你没有办法想象你在那儿给弟兄姊妹那个影响力有多大。
And you don't have any clue about the impact that your ministry did in Shantung. So now I'm going to give you some feedback.
他们去年的时候
，Last year, the church of
他们在给我打电话，云弟兄，无论如何，你是福音传回耶路撒冷了，发起人，你过去给我父亲同工，现在我们真正要响应这个呼召，要进入到巴基斯坦。
2 years ago, the leader of that church, Brother Chu, he called me.And he said, Brother Hyun, we know that you have been igniting the vision of back to Jerusalem among us and also around the world. And now the Lord has spoken to us that we are going to go to Pakistan.
他说你已经答应过，你说西方的门，东方这个穆斯林地区的门开了，你要我们去，你说我们如果去了以后，你一定要来，但是我们已经来了，你现在必须要来。
They said, the door is wide open for us. We are just going in. But we have one request. You have to come to Pakistan.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我万万没有想到我开始和我的儿子，我们开始然后从杜拜转飞机到那边的时候，竟然是一些军队的人，他们开始到那个机场来接我们，真枪实弹。
And I can hardly believe what happened when together with my son, we arrived to the international airport in Lahore. There was a government delegation and a red carpet waiting for me when I stepped out from the plane.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
他们就在告诉我一件事情，他说巴基斯坦穆斯林地区的人不喜欢美国人，但也不喜欢欧洲人，可是现在自从春节那个巴基斯坦的总统来拜访习近平以后，中巴基斯坦向中国的门是百分之百的开了。
And the brother told me an amazing story. The door to do any spiritual impact in Pakistan is closed for Americans, it's closed for Europeans. But because the president of Pakistan visited China when the dedication of the new president took place, now the door into Pakistan is overwhelmingly open for Chinese. Any Chinese have access.
哈利路亚！那个国会议员告诉我说：“云弟兄，不是你尊荣啊，是你这个国家时候到了。我们的总统给我们开会，就是说，每一个中黄皮肤中国人来到巴基斯坦是必须是受保护的，不能有任何问题出现。”
And his brother's one congressman, a Christian congressman of Pakistan, they are in very small minority. He said, "This is not anything that you have done."But God used this highest level of connection between the president of Pakistan and China so that when the president of Pakistan came back to Pakistan, he commanded that the army and the police force have to protect every yellow-skinned person in Pakistan.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
那天我就开始站在那宣讲耶稣基督，在一个那基督徒的村庄，那个警察们呢，他们都在外面站着岗，外面那个喇叭，全村庄每一个地方都要听。
And I was so pleased when I was proclaiming the gospel of Jesus Christ that the whole neighborhood was surrounded with the police force with their guns, that they protected totally my security.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我们现在能够做什么？
What can we do?
神给中国宣教士有一个应许，就是把福音传回耶路撒冷村，中国的西部整个都是七个坛的国家。
God has given to His church is to go to every nation, every people group between China and Jerusalem.
从人人为之都是说不可能的，可是神这么多的可能的事。
For the man, this is impossible.
过去只是一个意象，现在一批又一批的宣教士
住进
了穆斯林地区的不同的地方。
Tens of years, this has been a vision in the minds and hearts of the church in China. But today, it is reality. The Chinese are moving to these nations between China and Jerusalem.
Hallelujah.
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 他们把那一块土地埋下来，现在有几十个人在到那儿，来怎样用最新的科技来改变那里的。
The Shantung Church have a mission center.In the outskirts of Lahore, and there are more than 25 missionaries who are working out from that center, and they have totally protection by the local police and army.
那是一个比较最贫穷落后的地方。后来，啊，若比跟这个汤姆说，我们要帮助他们，将来有一天，他们只有太阳没有水。
And the location where they have started, they are surrounded by orphans. Their people are really poor and suffering and suffering.So the Back to Jerusalem is in partnership with the Church of Shantung, and we will make difference for the people and the difference for Kingdom of God in the middle of
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
他们像马可所想的一样，就是照顾那些孤儿、残疾的那些穆斯林的基督徒村庄的孩子，卖给阿拉伯人，他们要把他埋回来。
To care for the widows, to care for the orphans, and to care for the poor, that is the core of good news of the gospel.
我去拜访他们为一个基督教学校的时候，开始他们校长和主任开始哭了。我说：“好像你们这个学校像一个粪场一样。”他说：“我们这个地方是最贫穷的一个地区，也是我们巴基斯坦唯一的基督教学校。”
I never forgot when I visited a local public school. It was so run down, and they had no resources, and I burst it in tears when I saw the misery in that school. But at the same time, I saw great opportunity for the gospel.
那我的祷告是渴望让这些孤儿被训练，有一天用他们的母语向他们的国家去传福音。
And I also got this kingdom vision that every orphan in Pakistan, if we are only be able to embrace them with love of God, and then we will train them, they become wonderful evangelists for the gospel among their own people group.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
可是那天晚上啊，国会的议员开始给我们所有中国来的宣教士开会。他说：“我是巴基斯坦这个国家唯一的基督徒国会议员。”
That evening, the last evening I was in the country, the congressman who is the only Christian background congressman at the Congress and Senate of Pakistan, he came to us and we had a meeting together.
他说：“我想要你们了解我们的宪法。如果你向非基督徒来传福音的时候，全部是杀掉，我们谁也救不了你。”
And he said that if you, as Chinese Christians, you go across the borders and you start to convert the Muslims, they will give you head cut, and we cannot help you.
他说：“不过你在我这里没有问题。他外面有好几个这个警察呀，走着六七个人来给他站岗的。”
He said, "As long as you are close to me, you are totally protected. But if you do something else, I cannot help you."
他说：“不过在我家里的时候，你们不要怕。突然间，圣灵就开始对我来讲话。”
And then he said, "If you are my guest in my house, you are fully protected."And suddenly, the Holy Spirit started to speak to me.
我说国会议员。
I said, dear congressman.
我说我有一句话要告诉你，不知道适合不适合，但我必须要告诉你。
I have a word from the Lord for you. I don't know if it fits, if you can receive it, but I will tell it anyway.
这是神借去先知撒加利亚告诉伊丽莎伯的话，那个所罗巴伯的话。
These are the words that the Holy Spirit spoke through His prophet to a yeah.
撒加利亚告诉所罗巴伯说：“你不是依靠势力，也不是依靠才能，乃是依靠万军之耶和华的灵才能行事。”
And when the Bible says that it's not by might, by power, but by the of the Lord, Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
那天我来讲到说，我说你不要意味着这个事情不能够改变。中东这一块地区，这个大山要被挪开，是依靠神的灵。
And I told this brother that the great mountain that is hindering the gospel to reach the Middle East will be removed by the power of living God.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
我说中东地区目前这个问题是事实，不代表真理，这是主告诉我。
The problems in the Islamic world when it comes to the gospel are real, but they are not the truth. Jesus Christ is the truth, and He will set them free.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah. 我在监牢里的时候。我也认为不可能从四道天门能够走出去，可是主说：“孩子，我知道监狱是实实，但我是信实的。”
I remember 1997 when I was in that solitary confinement in that number one security prison, and the Lord said to me, "Stand up and walk out." I said, "Lord, this is a security prison. You don't walk out from places like that." And immediately Jesus replied, "Your prison is real, but I'm the truth. Stand up and walk out."
Hallelujah. 我那天开始给他来做见证。
And I started to share testimony to these people.
我说你可能不了解我生命中的故事，我现在要告诉你。
It may happen that you haven't read my life story, my testimony. I really want to inform you, to share with you.
我在问这个，我说耶稣怕不怕敌人？他说当然不怕了。
And then I asked, have a survey. I asked this man, do you think that Jesus is frightened of his enemies?
我说不但他不怕敌人，而且他要在敌人面前还要为我们摆设宴席。
And if you believe that Jesus is not afraid of his enemies, and he's that much not afraid that he has promised, I will prepare a table, feast table for you in the presence of your enemies.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我问各位，耶稣怕癌症不怕？
Now I ask you, is Jesus afraid of cancer? No.
耶稣不怕。
Jesus is not.
耶稣说你也不要怕。
And that's why he said, "Don't be afraid."
魔鬼可以在教会的里面兴风作浪，魔鬼在天上有没有权利？
Satan is creating havoc on this earth, but does he have any authority in heaven, in kingdom of God?
所以耶稣说：“你们要大胆地祷告，说我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同在天。”
Pray this prayer, May your kingdom come on the earth.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我们要祷告。
We have to pray.
愿神的国降临在我们中间，降临在美国这个国家。
So that the kingdom of God will be established in our midst, in our nation of America.
神的国要开始降临在印度，要降临在东亚一些穆斯林地区。
And the kingdom of God will be established in India, in Nepal, and throughout Central Asia and Middle East.
Hallelujah.联合国解决不了的问题，不代表耶稣解决不了。耶稣说：“你们要去，是万民做我的门徒。”
The solution that Jesus have is so much better than the solution for peace in Middle East of United Nations. Jesus say, "You go and preach the gospel of my kingdom."
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
所以我刚刚的预言就是要叫马可，你必须要知道， 全世界魔都陷在这个魔鬼的网络之下要被杀掉的时候，神要兴起摩底改，神要兴起以斯帖说用快马加鞭把腓尼基击出来。
I said this with Brother Mark before the meeting. God is about to bring end the influence of darkness upon this generation, and the light of Jesus will shine upon the nations.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
神要使用你的网络，你的电视台。
And the Lord want to use your programs on internet and in television. Take that for kingdom purposes.
神要使用小孩子的五个饼两个鱼掰开，让那个饥饿的人得不到饱足。
Five fish and two bread of the little child, and it will be a blessing to multitudes.
神要用你银行里的金钱掰开去传福音，去差遣人，把圣经、把神的话语送进中东。
And God is that you invest with your money to kingdom of God, it will be multiplied so many hundred times.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
如果你现在是在一个恐惧不安的监牢里，不要怕，耶稣能够剪断你这个恐惧不安的灵。
Now maybe you are in a turmoil in your life, and you have no peace, no joy in your life. He is here to set you free from that prison.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
有多少人你渴望跟随耶稣做主的门徒去？
Now, how many of you are not candidates to say to Jesus, I want to be your disciple, and I want to go wherever you send me.
Yeah.
Amen.
如果你愿意来跟随耶稣，你就和我一同站起来，我们要宣告神的国开始降临。
If you want to join me as I am following Jesus, I really ask you to stand up and give your life as a living sacrifice.
我知道当你去的时候，神迹其实会随住你。
When you in obedience to him, you start to go, Bible says that the signs and wonders will follow after you.
你不要怕魔鬼，你奉耶稣的命宣告，正要践踏魔鬼。
God has given you authority to step on the head of Satan, and you will be victorious.
你不要怕病痛，我们奉耶稣的名就是要医治病痛的。
And don't be frightened about multitudes of sicknesses in people's bodies. In the name of Jesus, you will bring healing to those who are sick.
Hallelujah!
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 Oh, 主耶稣，愿你的国现在就降临在我们的中间。
Thank you, Lord, that your kingdom is established in our midst.
当我们宣告的时候，愿你的旨意就行在每个人的生命中，如同在天上。
And as we are proclaiming, may your will be done in our lives. It start to happen in our lives, in our families.
我现在奉你的名宣告，你的国就降临在中东、以色列、穆斯林地区的每一个地区。
And I thank you, Lord, that your kingdom is now taking shape.In Middle East, Central Asia, all the way to Israel.
我今天要奉耶稣基督的名宣告，你受的鞭伤也要医治我们中间一些癌症、疾病。
And in your name, Lord, be proclaimed, because of your stripes and wounds, we are healed.
我要奉耶稣的名，要剪断我们中间心中那种恐惧、忧虑和不安。
And in the name of Jesus, we will set people free from that inner pressure, and they have no peace. They will be set free.
我知道你的心门已经开始打开。
I can sense that the doors of your heart they start to open for God's kingdom to enter into your daily life.
不管你过去是什么意向，神正在更新你的意向。
It doesn't matter what the vision of your life has been in the past.God is about to give some more understanding for you about your personal vision and the future of your life.
神正在扩展的不是你的计划，神有一个国度要在你的心中。
God is expanding your plans. He is expanding His kingdom.
神要用你，他要呼召你。
And He wants to use your life for His purpose.
他要呼召你去改变这个世界。
And He's calling you, join with me and transform this generation for My glory.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided 在地 To follow Jesus No turning back No turning 我们再一次来宣告我已经决定要跟随耶稣
Let's proclaim that we are decided to follow Jesus
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus.
I have decided.
如果你决定跟随耶稣的人，你可以从你的座位上走出来。我愿意为你祷告，马可，我们的同工们要为你祷告。
No turning back. And now we are inviting you to come. If you want to receive the fullness of His presence into your life, you are welcome to come, and we are willing to pray with you and release the kingdom anointing upon your life.
You can come out. You decide to follow Jesus. We want to be
with
you. I want to pray for you.
I'm willing to follow you.
敬拜你，他们是祷告，哈利路亚，主耶稣。